Hello guys, welcome to Veterinary Studies YouTube channel. This is a series of lectures on veterinary anatomy. From today, I am going to start a series of lectures on different bones of a skeletal system. Today's our topic is scapula. These are the contents which I am going to discuss in today's lecture. Let's start. Before going to my topic, I want to tell you about animal skeleton. Animal skeleton is divided into axial skeleton and appendicular skeleton. Axial skeleton comprises of skull, vertebral column, ribs, and sternum. Whereas appendicular skeleton consists of pectoral girdle, pelvic girdle, forelimb, and hind limb. There is a variance in the bones and shape of a pectoral and pelvis girdle in different species of animal. I will discuss pectoral and pelvis girdle in next slide. Forelimb includes humerus, radius ulna bone, small carpal bone, metacarpal bone, and phalanges. Hind limb includes femur bone, patella, tibia fibula, small tarsal bone, metatarsal bone, and phalanges. Pectoral girdle and pelvic girdle. Pectoral girdle, which is also known as shoulder girdle. If we see the pectoral girdle of a poultry birds, it comprises of pair of a coracoid, furcula, and scapula bone. In case of a human, pectoral girdle consists of pair of a scapula and clavicle bone. In human, clavicle bone is also known as a beauty bone, mostly in women, because in human this bone is a prominent in the body, and this bone also indicates the fat content of the body. So it means a woman who are thin or smart have a prominent clavicle bone as compared to fat or obese woman. However, in case of a domestic animal, pectoral girdle consists of only pair of a scapula bone. Pelvic girdle. Pelvic girdle consists of Oscoggi bone. Oscoggi bone is formed by the fusion of three pair bones, ilium, ischium, and pubis bone. These are the picture of a Oscoggi bone of a bird, human, and cattle. If we see the pelvic girdle of a chicken, Oscoggi bone is fused with the syncecrum. Syncecrum is a complex bone which is formed by the fusion of a 7 sacral and 6 caudal vertebrae. Moreover, 6 posterior caudal vertebrae of a chicken form a bone called pygostyle. Position of scapula. These are the position of a scapula in a different species of animal. This is the position of a scapula in human, in cattle, in goat, in horse, cat, and dog. Scapula. Scapula is also known as a shoulder blade. It is a flat bone. If you see the shape of a scapula bone, it is a triangular in outline. If you see the position of a scapula bone in different species of animal, it lies at the cranial part of the thoracic wall, and the direction of the bone is cranioventral direction. Scapula bone has two surfaces, three borders, and three angles. Surfaces. There are two surfaces of a scapula bone, medial surface and lateral surface. Medial surface is also known as a costal surface because it is facing toward the body or ribs. At the medial surface, there is a shallow depression called subscapular fossa, which is the site of attachment of a serratus ventralis muscle. And lateral surface is divided into two fossa by a spine, supraspinous fossa and infraspinous fossa. Supraspinous fossa is so called because it is above the spine, and infraspinous fossa is so called because it is below to the spine. Supraspinous fossa is narrow and does not extend to the ventral part of the bone, whereas infraspinous fossa is wide and smooth at the upper part of the bone and narrow at the below. Infraspinous fossa is the site of attachment of an infraspinous muscle. Spine. Spine is a point projection which divide the lateral surface into supraspinous fossa and infraspinous fossa, and it bend caudally in its middle and rostrally at ventral side. Spine extend from the dorsal border to the neck of the bone to form a point projection called acromion, which is the site from where a deltoid muscle arises. Angles. There are three angles of a scapular bone: cranial angle, which is facing toward the head; caudal angle, which is facing toward the tail; and ventral angle, which is facing toward the body. Ventral angle is also known as a glenoid angle because it bears a glenoid cavity. Cranial angle, which is thin and it is located at the junction of a craniodorsal border. Caudal angle, which is thick and rough and it is located at the junction of a dorsocaudal border. Ventral angle. It bears a glenoid cavity for the articulation of a circular head of the humerus to form a shoulder joint or glenohumeral joint. At the ventral part of the scapular bone, there are two tubercles and one process. Tubercle. Tubercle is located at the caudolateral part of the scapular bone and it is the site of attachment of a tendon of a teres minor muscle. Supraglenoid tubercle. It is so called because it is above to the glenoid cavity. It is a large rough prominence and it is the site of attachment of a tendon of the bicep brachii muscle. Coracoid process. It is a small round projection and it is the site of attachment of a coracoid brachialis muscle. This is the ventral part of a scapular bone. This large one is a glenoid cavity. This is a large rough prominence known as a supraglenoid tubercle, and in some species it is a large in size, therefore it is also known as a supraglenoid tuberosity. This one is a coracoid process, and there is a small depression at the glenoid cavity known as a glenoid notch. Borders. There are three borders of a scapular bone: dorsal border, which is facing toward the vertebral column; cranial border, which is facing toward the head; and caudal border, which is facing toward the tail. At the dorsal border, there is a crescent shaped cartilage called scapular cartilage. Scapular cartilage increases the surface area of a scapular bone and it is also act as a shock absorber. Cranial border. Cranial border does not extend at the ventral part of the bone, therefore it forms a scapular notch at the level of a neck of the scapula. This is a neck of a scapula and this one is a scapular notch. Caudal border. Caudal border is marked by a several ridges for the attachment of a tricep muscle. This is a scapula of the horse. There are two surfaces of a scapula: lateral surface and medial surface. There are three angles of a scapula: cranial angle, which is facing toward the head; caudal angle, which is facing toward the tail; and ventral angle, which is facing toward the belly or body. There are three borders of a scapula: cranial border, which is facing toward the head; caudal border, which is facing toward the tail; and dorsal border, which is facing toward the vertebral column. This is a spine. This one is a supraspinous fossa. This one is a infraspinous fossa. There is a glenoid cavity at the ventral angle, and this one is a supraglenoid tubercle. At the medial surface, there is a shallow depression called subscapular fossa. I will discuss scapula in 3D model in my next lecture. This is another picture of a scapular bone of a different animals. This is a lateral and medial surface of a dog scapula. This one is a scapula of a small ruminant, and this one is a pig scapula. Glenoid cavity. It is a cavity at the ventral angle or ventral part of the scapula bone for the articulation of the scapula with the humerus head to form a glenohumeral joint or shoulder joint. This is more clear picture of a ventral part of the scapula. This is the glenoid cavity. This one is a coracoid process. This one is a supraglenoid tubercle. This is a spine. At the end of the spine, there is a acromion. This one is a supraspinous fossa. And this one is a infraspinous fossa. This is all about scapula bone. If you like this lecture, press like button. If you want a latest update regarding my YouTube channel, press bell icon. And don't forget to subscribe my YouTube channel. Thank you.